it is a ruin and a part of the process to take you closer to Jesus.
Oh, yes.
It will be proof that you have separated yourself from the life you used to lead. And somebody may not want to believe it. Somebody may be opposing it this morning. Or somebody, praise God.
Oh,
yeah. But it's not about us. At the end of the day, pastors, every man, boy or girl, must give account.
Oh,
hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Mama can't answer for you. Oh, daddy can't answer for you. I don't know, grandparents love their grandchildren even sometimes more than the natural parents do. Or grandpa or grandma can answer for you. Or somebody, praise God. At the end of life's journey, every man will be answering for themselves when the roll is called. Every one of you this morning holding a light in your hand. Sitting on these chairs, you will give account. You will answer to God.
And
so this morning, I would not want this to miss me. And I tell you that, the right, sit on for a moment. Right to declare that God move in a mysterious way. Yes, declare that His wonders to perform. He plants His footsteps on the sea, and He rides upon the storm. And at one point, it didn't seem possible that I would be here in this year's convention. Oh, bless the name of the Lord. A few weeks ago, could be a month or so ago, brother had asked me, Bishop, are you going to be coming for convention? And I said, boy, it looks so, but I'm going to try my very best. In the back of my head, I'm saying, amen, I can't, I don't want to tell it no, but in the back of my head, I'm saying it's not going to be possible.
Amen.
Oh, praise the name of Jesus. Amen, amen. Growing up, they used to talk about Brother Nancy. About the Brother Nancy story. Amen. Brother Nancy said, well, two trouble better than one. Oh, you don't know. Nobody knows that. Amen. I look young, but I'm not all that young. Oh, somebody praise the name of the Lord. So two trouble, bless the name of the Lord, has afforded me the privilege or the opportunity to be here this morning. And so I rejoice in the Lord. Oh, somebody praise the name of Jesus. And I rejoice in the fact that, bless God, we are now not just doing what we always do in the norm. Oh, bless the name of the Lord. But we are doing things a little bit different. Somebody praise God. Somebody bless the name of the Lord. And I rejoice that, bless God, it's not happening tomorrow morning when there's so much for me to do tomorrow. Oh, praise God. I'm happy it's happening this morning so I can come, go back to Kingston, be at church, go to Clarendon, leave Clarendon, come back, go to the yard and get ready for funeral tomorrow morning. Do not have me back here tomorrow night. Oh, bless the name of the Lord. I just bless God. And I'm just rejoicing that He is working in the manner that He's working. Oh, praise the name of Jesus. Oh, praise the name of the Lord. And it's often that the church, amen, is looked at as a woman. And the church is called her. Because the church should be giving birth. Somebody bless the name of the Lord. And so this morning it is proof, pastors, that praise God, your labor is not in vain. Every woman, amen, that I know, or for that matter, most women, oh, praise God, doesn't feel an accomplished woman or accomplished female unless she has a child. Or somebody praise God. And in this age, women don't matter whether they're married or they're not married or not. They just know that they want a child.
Amen.
And so if we look at it in that sense, the church should also adopt the same principle. That whatever means we have to use, or praise God, to travel and to give birth, and let it be known that the church is a place where people can still come and get deliverance. Oh God Almighty, the church is still a place where people can come and find Jesus.
Amen.
We need that. Jesus still saves.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And so, praise God, the church today has not only given birth to one. I don't know what you call this amount. I don't know how much of them. I stopped counting. Because I'm claiming more. But bless the name of the Lord. I'm stopped counting because I'm claiming more. You're getting it.
Amen.
I'm not even counting what, who's there in the Bible.
Praise the Lord.
I'm claiming more in the name of Jesus. Somebody bless the name of the Lord. And I don't know what you're content in the numerical order. I know if it's one, they call it one. And if it's two, they say it's twin. I know if it's three, you get triplet. And I know some women have a four. And they call it quadruplet. What? Quadruplet. Am I right? So I don't know if what you would call ten. Oh, that's the name of the Lord. But I just rejoice. I tell you, church, we should be glowing in this house. We should be tearing this
house. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
Church of Marina, where I get 10 young people one time.
Amen. Praise God.
Amen. So much is going on in our churches. So much is happening around our churches. So in one corner, much less 10 corner, we should be rejoicing. And I must take my hat off to the pastors here, Bishop Hanshaw. And Pastor Hanshaw and the team that work over here. For doing the work you are doing.
Praise the Lord.
Bless the name of the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
I, as the overseer, it is always nice for me to walk in and hear Bishop yes, of our baptism. And even if I did one bishop, we still will come up here this morning.
Oh, yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
Because I feel good.
Yeah.
Somebody bless the name of the Lord.
Yeah.
Because you know how I look at it? Your achievement is my achievement.
Yeah.
Hello, people. And if we begin as Christians to begin to adopt this principle that when one person is blessed, you feel like a you blessed. When one person is lifted up, you feel like a you lifted up. Oh, somebody praise God.
Yeah.
Listen, man, when you hear that one person child pass exam, feel good for them.
Amen.
Somebody bless the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Come on, people of God.
Amen.
Happening for a brother or a sister, rejoice with them more so it is happening in our church. And so today I give God thanks.
Amen.
I give God thanks. I give God thanks. With his own sin. Somebody bless the name of the Lord. I trust that God will surround them.
Oh yes.
Put a fence around them. I trust that angels will be dispatched out of heaven.
Amen.
One each for one of them.
Amen.
Oh, praise God to stand God for them.
Amen.
Because the word of God said, I will give my angels charge over thee.
Yes.
To keep thee, you praise God. Oh, somebody praise God.
Praise God.
And when you look at that, they are young folks, they are young people. It means that the church is going to be taken up to another level. You see, people like me, old people like me, oh, praise God, when gray coming now, come back. Amen. Instead of here getting them black, I get gray. It's simply even going downhill. So somebody else must take over.
Oh,
praise God. We must increase and allow others to increase. Oh, somebody praise God.
Praise the Lord.
That's why I rejoice this morning. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you.
Amen.
I am just happy.
Amen.
I don't know if you feel like a wife, but I'm just happy.
Praise God.
I'm just happy.
Amen.
If I had to walk from Kingston to Richmond, I would have done that. But I'm just happy.
Oh, yes.
Oh, somebody bless me.
Praise the Lord.
And I'm claiming more this morning. Hallelujah. I know God is going to move.
Amen.
He has moved, oh, praise God. And I know he's going to move again.
Praise the Lord.
Somebody bless the name of the
praise
Lord.
The Lord.
So praise God. I trust that as these young ones have come, I'm one thing I'm hoping for, Church of God, is that we're prepared to be mothers and fathers. I'm gonna finish here. We're gonna go over the candidates, so take them to the river side. But I want to leave this word with you, people of God, because oftentimes, oh praise God, people don't know how to look after children. Oh, somebody bless the name of the Lord. So we gotta claim these as our own. Whether they're maternal or paternal, parent is in the house, praise the name of the Lord. Whether you have a blood relation to them, you gotta know, take them as yours. And when I say take them as yours, you gonna go look after them well. Oh, bless the name of the Lord. Make sure that their needs are met as it becomes necessary. Oh, somebody bless the name of the Lord. You're going to make sure you look out for them. You're going to make sure that you realize that they are still young people. And as much as they are surrendering their lives to God, amen, righteousness and holiness don't happen overnight. So you're going to help them on the